One of the first questions, does facial recognition technology work as advertised? USA Today's Ed Baig saying, this is probably the number one question on people's minds. It certainly was mine. And so far, Apple has passed the test with flying colors. Baig says Face ID worked even when he wore a hat, sunglasses, or both. Baig says the 10 leaves, in his words, a strong first impression. Now, over at The Verge, Nili Patel gave his take. He's a fan of that new display, writing, the iPhone 10 OLED is bright, sharp, vibrant, without verging into parody, and generally a constant pleasure to look at. As for Face ID, Patel says it mostly works great, though sometimes he says it was inconsistent in bright sunlight. However, he still says it's the best iPhone ever made. Remember, a big reason people upgrade their phones is because of better cameras. Mashable's Lance Ulanoff saying, not only are the lenses and image sensors better than ever, but the algorithms backing them are taking mobile photography to new heights. So when can you get your hands on an iPhone 10? Supply looks like it could be tight, at least initially. UBS estimates there will be just 28 million iPhone 10 models available in the December quarter.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.